At this point, we have our player object set up, and we've got an asteroid being spawned every 5 seconds. But when the asteroid comes in contact with the player, nothing happens. It just flies over the ship. We need to destroy the player's ship when it collides with the asteroid. To do this, we need to use collision detection to determine when the asteroid sprite is overlapping the player sprite. Luckily, Construct 3 does most of the work for us, and all we have to do is set up the collision polygon. The collision polygon is an area within the sprite that determines where collisions will be triggered. Every sprite has its own collision polygon, which you can edit to match the actual shape of the sprite. Before we edit the collision polygons, though, let's set up the event that fires off when the collision occurs. I'll add an event using the asteroid object. Under the collisions category, choose on collision with another object. We want to check if the asteroid has collided with the player. And click done. Now, when the asteroid collides with the player, we want to destroy the ship. So let's add an action. Using the player object. And choose destroy. So, when the asteroid collides with or overlaps the player ship will be destroyed. Let's preview the layout. And if I let an asteroid hit the ship, it's destroyed. But if you notice, the asteroid didn't really collide with the player. It only came close, but the event was triggered anyway. The reason why is the collision polygon defaults to a bounding box, taking up this whole square. If I drag the asteroid next to the ship, look at the corners of the boxes. The actual sprites are not touching, but their boxes are overlapping. We need to edit the collision polygons so that they conform to the actual shape of the ship and the asteroid. To edit it, double-click on the player sprite and open the animations editor. On the left toolbar, click the last button, Edit the Collision Polygon. This blue box is the collision polygon, and you can adjust it by dragging these points. You can also add points by right-clicking a point and choosing Add Point. In general, you should keep these points to a minimum, because the more there are, the more calculations need to be done to check for collisions. Keep the number of points to a minimum, just enough to get the shape you need. We don't need to match each angle perfectly, just surround the sprite as close as possible. And we'll do the same thing to the asteroid. Add a new point, and adjust it. And I'll add one more. Okay, that looks good. If I preview the game, and let the asteroid hit the ship, it destroys it, but only when it actually comes in contact, once the collision polygons overlap. This is an essential part of making a game, because you're always checking for collisions, taking damage when you collide with an enemy, collecting a power-up, or checking when a bullet you fired hits an enemy, which is what we'll do in the next video. We need to give our player the ability to shoot, so we can fight back against the asteroids that can now destroy us.